In this screencast, we're going to use Excel's data table analysis to solve the following problem. Let's say you want to buy a new house, which costs $150,000, and you need to get a loan to pay for it. So you want to know, with an interest rate of 3.75%, what your monthly payment would be if you want to pay it off in 30 years. You also want to know if the interest rates vary from 2.5% to 10%, how this monthly payment would change. We're going to take a look at Excel and see how to answer both of these questions. So let's fill in the blanks right here. Our loan amount is $150,000. Our time to pay it off is 30 years. However, since we're going to pay it monthly, we're actually going to have 360 payments, and our percentage is going to be 3.75%. Notice it writes it as 0.0375. Now, in order to figure out the monthly payment, we use the Excel function payment. So it takes five arguments, the first three which are pertinent to this problem. So the first argument is the rate or interest rate. So that's going to equal our 3.75%. But remember, that's an annual interest rate. So you're going to have to divide this by 12. The second one is the number of payments, which is right here. And finally, the present value of the house, or the amount of loan you're going to need. So when you put those values in, you end up with a monthly payment of $694.67. Now, let's take a look at our scenario if the interest rates are changed. So the first thing we're going to do is put together an interest rate column, and that's going to equal 2.5%. That's where we're going to start. And now we want this to go all the way to 10%. And what I'm going to use here is the fill series, and we're going to fill the column. And our step value, remember it's in percentage, is 0.005, which is 0.5%. And our stop value is 10% or 0.1, and we say OK, and it fills in our column. By the way, if we wanted to change this to percentage, we select the whole column, we right-click, we format the cells to percentage, and now it's a percentage. The next thing we do is we put in the formula for monthly payment. And the best way to do that is just take the formula from before and put it at the top. Now we want to be able to fill in all these numbers. So we highlight both columns, making sure we have that original monthly payment that we calculated earlier in the two columns. We go to data and what if analysis and data table. So we're working in columns, so we want a column input cell. And what is this column input cell? Well, it's the variable that we are going to change in order to get different monthly payments. And that variable is our interest rate. So we click on that and we say OK, and the table gets filled in. Now, you might wonder why these all look different from our payment on the top, and that's just a matter of formatting. Again, we will right-click, click Format Cells, and now we go to Currency. And the way we had formatted it before was a number in red with parentheses around it to indicate that it was a negative number. So here we have a table of what the monthly payments would be based on different interest rates.